Hi students, welcome back. Now coming to the next topic in the subject, computer graphics is data compression. Data compression. So what it means, you are compressing the data. Means you are reducing the size of the file without affecting the original file. Okay, so far you have seen the zip files. So the zip file, it's just compressing file. If you are having this so much of large file, if you want to send that file to any person, you need to compress. Otherwise, you can't send that much of large file to another file through internet. Okay, so that is a data compression. Now let's see what is exactly it is. A data compression is a function of presentation layer in the OSI. It's just the OSI reference model. It's just a function of presentation layer. The presentation layer is going to do this data compression. A compression is often used to maximize the use of bandwidth across. Okay, first, it is used to maximize the use of bandwidth. Use of bandwidth across a network, or to optimize disk space. To optimize means to reduce the disk space. Optimize disk space when saving data. So for this, the compression is used to maximize the use of bandwidth over the network and to optimize the disk space. So what exactly the data compression is? Let me explain you. What is data? Let me write DC, data compression. What is data compression? The definition of data compression is the art of representation of information in a compact form, means it's a small form, in a compact form is called data compression. It is an art of representing an information in a compact form. So, what type of information you are using, how much size your information is, means the data is, it's just representing in a compact form, is called data compression. So, these representations are created by identifying and using the structures in the data. So, that you had to be remembered. Okay, I said the data compression is nothing but it's an art of representation of information in a compact form. Actually, why we require this data compression? Why is it necessary? Why is data compression? Okay, so we are using, why the data compression is required means for the sake of storage and for the sake of data transmission. Okay, so why we require data compression means for the sake of storage and for the sake of data transmission. Suppose storage, how this data compression will be used? The data compressions reduce the size of the file. Reduce the size of a file. Okay, to reduce the storage space requires to store the particular file, it has to reduce the size of the file. Then what about the data transmission? So how this data compression is used in the for the sake of data transmission? It saves the time. It saves the time that is required in transmitting file. That is required in transmitting file. So for these two reasons we are using the data compression, for storage and for data transmission. Actually, the data compression involves two main components. Generally, the data compression involves two main components. So what are the two main components? The two main components are encoding algorithm and decoding algorithm. Encoding algorithm and decoding algorithm. So for every, if you want to compress the original data, if you are using the data compression technique on any file, you need encoding algorithm for compress the data and to Deactivate means the compressed data, you need the decoding algorithm. Actually, this encoding algorithm takes a message, whatever the message or a file that is there, it takes a message and generates a compressed representation. Of that message. So whatever the message that is there, that should be compressed in encoding algorithm. What about the decoding algorithm? What this decoding algorithm will do? This decoding algorithm reconstruct the original message. Reconstruct the original message. Okay? Or some approximate of it from the compressed representation. So these are the main two components that are involved in the data compression. Okay? So I hope you understand what exactly the data compression is. If you want to save the storage, means if you want to reduce the size of the storage, and if you want to transfer the data for data transmissions, we are using the data compression. Actually, this data compression is an art of representation of information in a compact form. Okay, so in the next video, I'll explain the different data compression techniques or the methods. How the data is compressed by using different techniques. Okay, how it is going to be save the storage, means reduce the size of the storage, size of the file, and how the files are transmitting to save the time. Thank you.